and can't be bothered the rest of the season. But I mean, yeah, I really don't know how it's going on with Maverick, to be completely honest with you. So yeah, a few other guys I know that are also coming and doing on laps. Like you say, there's a few more people within here that are in this championship fight. Luke being one of them, who's done a 16.6 on a set of the medium tyres. So not a bad lap at all from the Aston Martin driver. But I'm surprised he's doing a set of mediums, maybe just getting a feel for the track as well, as a few of the other people that are out on track currently as well. But yeah, I mean, you see this title battle, the four-way battle between Tope, Luke, Rick and RJ, I think it's going to, especially with Hungary being probably one of the only other wheel tracks on this left on this calendar with Canada, I think this is going to make this a very interesting race. And I think from this race, I think we might actually see who will be in this title battle and who won't be on this title battle.
Yes, as Cam very kindly put together for the second week in a row, championship permutations as well, to see who would be eliminated if people do as well. And obviously since Tope, where is he out on track at the moment? He is on track, going towards the middle sector. So if basically Tope does well, then Bunty, Cam, Old School and Rex will be at threat from being out of the championship. And obviously Darry must finish in a certain position as well. And even on the rare occasion Darry is to not score well, then Bunty, Cam and Old School must win. So, you know, those people are the ones under threat, and that will probably potentially put the top four that will definitely be in contention after this week, but everyone else is pretty much in danger. Obviously, you've got a lot of people that are out of this title fight after Tope and Rakurik scoring like they did last week, as Tope up to the line, continuing his form as he showed last week with a 1:15.0. I think he's going to be the first man into the 1:14, you know, as we get to the latter stages of qualifying. We've got HYY's teammate Rakurik about to start his lap. You know what, since he's on the soft tyres, we may as well take you through a lap as we head towards turn number one. DRS zones follow directly after each other as well, and as we acted to that just right, you're going to be short shifting a little bit in into fourth gear to third gear on exit there as well, as he's going to be heading towards, I need to get my track map up to see what corner it is, as heading towards turn four and five, and this is where you can run really wide, and seen a few people invalidate there in practice, including myself as well. Heading towards, well, the second set, double right-hand chicane in turn six and seven, clips that curve very, very well indeed on entry as well. You can lose a lot of time if you don't hit that curb too much, but you don't want to hit fully on the curb because you end up spinning. And it is completely flat through here as well. You don't need to brake too much as you head towards the 100-meter board as well. Right-hand curb, he's not too bad, but I'm sure there's another people that can go a lot faster compared to the Haas driver right now. But surely, since he lost his championship lead, he needs to find a lot of time left on the table as we head towards the final corner of turn 14. Keep to the attack and defence for this driver, and he's only P10, 1:15.6, and that's 6 tenths off Tope in P1 right now. So Tope has just sent a benchmark. Neil's in P2. Cam had actually set a good lap just now as well. He's sought his car into P3, 7 tenths quicker than his previous best there. So yeah, I think it shows who's made of the right stuff. But the ones that need to do well, like Cam for example, well, he's put his car in a very good position.
Yeah, no, he certainly has. Cam actually, again, the other one come up from D4. Sorry, I would say Cam's probably made more of a impact on Division 4 than what his teammate has so far. So I think Cam was one of the only ones that had been scoring pretty much every single race up until, I mean, it was only two rounds ago. So, yeah, Cam's done a very good, has been very well in recent races, well, throughout this entire season, because he was one that I wouldn't have to be up there within the top 10 in the standings. And if, correct me if I'm wrong, I believe he's currently sitting in P8 in the standings. So yeah, he's doing very well so far in the season, because I'm sure he won't mind me saying he's not exactly the quickest in the division, but he's probably one of the most consistent in the division. And I mean, the consistency is keeping him within that top 10 in the standings. So I mean, fair play to him for that. Again, I think that's the complete polar opposite, though, of Marty. Marty just seems to be very quick coming from Division 4, but then just can't seem to hang it out in the race. And it's just, I don't know what keeps on happening around with him. He just can't seem to hold it together within a race, or within a race distance, but he is very quick over one lap pace. I'm running on board with one of the championship protagonists of XLRJ, but he's just coming into the pits, and in fact he's put himself into P5, 1,000th behind Marty, interestingly enough. So he needs to get a little bit further up if he still wants to have any contention of being within this championship, because as I said, I feel like today will probably show who will still be left in this championship fight and who might be missing out as well. So, I don't know. I really think this could be a bit of an interesting race. I have been told that we do need to restart after qualifying, so we definitely won't be able to do any interviews. As Dari, 0.3 of a second up ahead of his teammate, a 14.792. The first one into the 14s.
Wow, 114.7, I have to say, that is pretty incredible. I was expecting his teammate Tope to do that, but that is quite a margin between himself and his teammate as well. Two drivers at the beginning of the season where I thought they were going to be the ones to do well in the constructors, but there's been some weeks where Dari hasn't been scoring very well compared to his teammate, but Dari has been showing on his day that he can deliver. He's currently sitting P6 in the standings. I'm just trying to see where he finished last week. He scored 5 points last week, so not in comparison to his teammate, but again, to finish first, you first have to finish, and with some drivers being consistent like Dari, if you finish in every race and score points, then you're going to be up there as well. As I think the setting they got wrong is gears, I believe. I'm not entirely sure. I don't know why they got that wrong, but so there will be a bit of a delay, which means me and Jake, I won't get as much practice time for our race, which is going to be happening at 8:10 tonight. But hey ho, I'm probably not going to do as well anyhow. As Tope is looking quick on his lap, then heading towards the final corner, first race to be held under the Iron Curtain. Let's see what he could do. Wow, 114.748. And Toby's just said, if anything, Dari could do, he could do better. And I just have to say, the Williams boys are looking very, very strong in snatching, pretty much extending their lead in the constructors. I need to find out who's leading the constructors, to be fair, but helping them in the constructors. I don't think Toby's going to have time for another lap unless he does a speedy in that. I don't think you're allowed to cut the corners, unfortunately, but there we go. So Tope in P1, Dowie P2, Neil's a new guy in P3, Cam in P4, Marty's just about to start his lap in P5, then we got RJ, Brent, Recurrit, Bunty, your top 10, and then we got Old School, Maverick, Noah J, Mats, Luke, YHYY, J Luke, Chill, who's retired, and Charlie, who's still on the mediums, believe it or not, as well. So Charlie hasn't gone out, I believe, was that. We might have invalidated, I'm not entirely sure. But a few drivers who I'm expecting to be up there, like Luke, the championship contender. Well, he hasn't shown his form so far in his qualifying session, and it's showing, because if he doesn't get a good lap, he needs to put it all on the line next week, because he may be eliminated next week.
Yeah, no, exactly. I was just trying to sort some stuff out in this Division 3 chat, because I've just found out Dari did end up joining late, and he has set a time. So luckily, I think it is because we are doing that restart, he's getting put at the back of the grid anyway, so he is not going to be starting up in P2. He will be starting down in P19, so I think that's been a bit more of a saving grace for him, that he's put a lap in, but because it's a restart anyway, he will be at the back of the grid. So Tope is the one that is still technically on pole, and Neil Shendrick is the one still in second place. Of course, we've got about 2.5 minutes left to go of the session, so it is all going to come down to these last set of laps and seeing who's going to come out on top with what. J Luke is on a lap currently, and he is just under a tenth up on his time. Coming through sector 2, though, he goes the tiniest bit wide at turn number 11, and that's invalidated his lap. 2 tenths up on his time. Still would have put him around where Noah J is, his teammate. So very unfortunate for him. In fact, Noah J, it said he's about 3.5 tenths up on his lap, but I think he's already done 2 laps on those set of soft tyres. So I think that's pretty much his qualifying over and done with. Right on board with American of IRT Rex, just starting his lap. In fact, coming around to turn number 1 now. And we'll stick on board with the American, because again, he's been one that's a little bit of an underdog, in my opinion. Again, he's taken one race win already this season at Britain, and I mean, that was in wet conditions as well. So with it being wet conditions tonight, we could be seeing the American have a pretty good race, considering that he's starting at the moment, he's in seventh and he's about a tenth and a half up on his time. I think Rex could be a little bit of an underdog, as we're still just watching him coming through sector two now, probably the tightest and twistiest part of the circuit. Obviously, I'd say this is more suited towards wheel users as well, as Noah J has retired from the session out of the penultimate corner, interestingly enough. So Noah J won't be able to improve on his time. Rex does keep it within those white lines and 2.5 temps up on his time. So this could put himself up into what would be a P2, as Marty, now the second or the third person, doing a 14.931. Can the other Alpine of Rex get himself up into the 14s as well? He's just making his way around the final corners. Bunty, 14.8 for the Alfa Romeo. Rex coming up towards the line, and it's not in the 14s, it's a 15.0, but P4 on the grid. This could be a good start for the Alpines. All they have to do really is just try and keep it on track, because it's not the easiest to overtake around here, especially in the wet.
As David comes across the line in pole position, but he's not going to stay there because obviously he's disqualified from qualifying. For those of you that don't know, if you do rejoin basically in qualifying, or if you join late, you're not allowed to set a lap, and he hasn't done that, so it's against the rules. So we're about to get to the end of qualifying as the checker flag is about to drop. Let's see who will be the first person to cross the line. Well, it won't be Ricciardo as he's retired. Why? Up to the line. I think he's made it just in time. Actually, no, he hasn't, but it's a 1:15.1. Very good lap time for him. Next across the line will be RJ, our championship protagonist, P5. Then we got Brent, who slots his car into P4 respectively. We got Marty, who's unfortunately invalidated, so he's going to go into the pit. We got RJ's teammate, Old School. Guess what? He has invalidated on his run. Then we have got Bunty, who has taken an interesting escape road there through the penultimate few corners, so he's not going to get a lap. But we got one of the Red Bulls. Who is it? We've got Cam up to the line. He's 12 for the moment. Can he get higher than that? 11. On a dry, on a strategy, this will work wonders for him, but he's not, and he's dropped down to 12th anyway, as Hendrick, I believe, goes a little bit faster as well. Maverick could only manage 10th. We've got, I think, Luke, who's invalidated, unfortunately. His teammate actually goes 4th. Tope up to the line. He matches his teammate, and it's a P1, 1:14.5. 3 tenths shy of the rest of the field, and I'm just trying to see if everyone else is on a lap. No, that is not on a lap. So we got Williams 1-2, but since Dale will be starting in the back, we got Tope in P1, Bunty P2. It's like the status quo over again from last week, so those two are battling quite a lot. And then we got the new guy, Niels, in P3. I have to say, good debut so far in Division 3, but he's got to see what he can do in the race.
Yeah, no, without a doubt. So that is qualifying all wrapped up. Tope I've just made a quick mistake. Yeah, very good qualifying for the two Williams. Of course, Darry, unfortunately, having to start at the back of the grid, considering that he did join in labour. Tope, what a qualifying lap that was from him. Same with Bunty. Bunty and Tope. It's been the story with just these two for the past two races now. And I think Tope and... I think Bunty's came into his own a little bit too late on in the season. Otherwise, I would say he is definitely up there for to be a championship contender. But yeah, Tope, Bunty on the front row of the grid, Neil Shendrick in third, with Brent in fourth, and all Dutch second row. Marty is in fifth, with RJ in sixth, Luke in seventh, Rex in eighth, YTRY in ninth, Maverick in tenth, Cam K in 11th. Like you say, that would probably be the best thing for him if it was a try start, but unfortunately it's a wet start for him. J-Luke will be 12th, Rick in 13th, Old School in 14th, Noah J in 15th, Mats will be 16th, Chill in 17th with no time, and crashing, I believe, in quali. Charlie not putting a lap on the board, and Darry, like I said, getting disqualified from the qualifying session because of him joining in late. So he will be starting at the very back of the grid. And I think this is going to make this a bit more interesting, to say the least. As I said, we have to do this restart. I'm just going to get the weather off of the guys from Division 3, and then we will go ahead and do this restart, only because it is hammering it down at the start. So we shall see how this is going to go down.
Yeah, so I need to leave the lobby before my game starts to crash, so I will do that right now. So hopefully everyone will get into the lobby very, very promptly. And because obviously we are going to be starting late and doing a lobby restart, no interviews today, so it will just be a long race. And I've just seen the weather forecast for the session to see what it is. So for the first five slots, first five slots are going to be wet. I'm not sure what the intensity is going to be, but it said it's going to be wet. The final two slots is going to be overcast, and then it's going to be sunny as well. So changeable condition for definite, but you never know with this game, with the lobby set to approximate. It could all change at any time, to be honest. So I'm expecting craziness at the moment in Hungary, as it usually does. And most of the race I've commented around Hungary, it's pretty much had a changeable condition race. So it's probably my fault that it's happened at the moment as well. So hopefully we could get started soon as well. And I have to say, a few people did not have the best of qualifying sessions, but they are going to have the benefit of having a clean slate starting on the wet, and they're going to be having some fresh tyres when they have the dry stints later on in the race.
Yeah, no, they certainly will. And talking about, obviously, their qualifying session, our championship, the person second in championship by 1 point, Rick, down in 14th position. That is not the start that he would need to have. He's done this plenty of times this season where he started towards the back, and I don't know how, but has managed to make his way through the grid. I say he's 14th, he'll be starting 30th because I forgot about Darry. So he'll be starting in P13 and has to try and make his way through the field. The rest of the championship protagonists, you've got Luke in 8th, RJ in 7th, and Tope obviously on pole. Tope's really just pushing himself more and more to get himself this championship already. I mean, if it was to stay the way that it is at the moment, with RJ in 6th and Luke in 7th, that's at least another, 17 more points that he jumps up ahead of him by? So, wow. And with Rick not scoring any points either, Tope basically has 3 rounds left to try and keep about a 20-point gap to the rest of those guys, and then it's basically just done and dusted for him. So, yeah, I think if it is going to be the case that Tope does manage to hold this off, if the other guys can't seem to make any sort of moves, especially, as I said, in the wet weather, I really don't. I can't see the sense of anybody else in Tope take this win.
The first time he actually won a race was last week, and nobody apart from yourself has won a race twice in a row. So he could be the second person this season, the German, to do so. And it took the whole of the season for him to get the win. His first podium was in Imola, and then he got a podium in round two, which I believe was Portugal. No, it wasn't Portugal. It was something else. No, it was France. I was close. Portugal was round three. He got 12 points in round three there as well. And then he hasn't DNF'd at all, actually. Every time he's finished, he's in the points because there was 2 races he couldn't make. So he's missed a consistent year as well. Same with Rakurik. He scored points in every race he competed. And same with, not RJ. He scored 0 points in Austria, I believe. And I'm just trying to see who's the first DNF on that list. I believe that's Brent, who's got 2 DNFs in this championship fight. So for him, he's got the one who's the most to lose in this situation, and the most to gain as well, because if he has a good result, then it should be fine. Now, I haven't got an invite yet, so I think Old School is setting up the lobby to make sure everyone joined in at the moment as well. Who do you see could be the big surprise? Because it's going to be a full wet start. Who's going to get the best start off the line?
Well, from what I've seen from last week, Bunty was the one that had the better start out of the two. Again, it was Tope and Bunty on the front row again. So I think we could be seeing the same thing happen between Bunty and Tope. I think Bunty could get the better start. It's just if he's going to be able to keep that lead in the race. Like I said, it's so difficult to overtake around here anyway. So I don't know. I really don't know how we're going to see this one play out. But I think we might see Bunty go into the lead into turn one, in my opinion. And we might even see a couple guys. I don't know what this Neil Shendrick's like. He could be maybe making a bit of a jump at the start as well on the rest of the guys. So, I really don't know how we're going to see this. If I'm a betting guy, though, I would probably put it as Bunty. That'll be leading into turn one.
There we go. Yeah, so I have to say I pretty much agree with you there as well, because I think Bunty has come a little bit more into his own the last couple of races. It's a bit of a shame that his form is starting to improve now rather than during the season, because Bunty was nowhere at the start of the season. First race, he scored 0 points. Second race, 0 points in France. Portugal, he only scored 1 point, and then it was DNF. Did not start. DNF. DNF in Austria, Monaco, Silverstone, and Saudi Arabia. He got 12 points in Bahrain. I'm just trying to remember the flags, actually. 1 point in Australia. He got a win in Belgium, his first win of the season, which I think sedimented his, well, pretty much kick-started his championship fight, to be honest. And then he got 5 points at Zandvoort. No points in Russia. Well, not Russia. So Ibo, also German. I need to forget Russia out of my mind. Then we got a podium last week in China, which I have to say was one of his best races of the season, apart from Belgium, where he delivered very, very well indeed. So, yeah, it's a shame his form has only improved towards the end of the season, but there is a chance that he can get in his fight, but everyone else behind it, in front of him, needs to pretty much not score points with him running every race, which is gonna be tough. But with him starting second, maybe he could get into the top five of the championship, maybe go into sixth place. We don't know. There's a lot of changes, I think, in his championship as well. And when certain protagonists, obviously fast drivers not here, like Pat, for example, he DNF'd last week, but in the race before that, he was absolutely astonishing. I could see Bundy have a good start up the line, but he's not as, I think I remember in Portugal when it was a wet start, I believe, to the race, he only scored 1 point, so let's hope there's not a repeat. I'm trying to see who else did well in the wet, actually. I think Luke did well in the wet. He had a P3, Ricciardo finished P2 in that race, and we've got, I think, Miami finished fourth. I'm trying to remember what the point system is in another way. I think it's 10 points, fourth or fifth place, I can't remember, but he scored 10 points anyway, so there we go. I think we're just waiting for, have we got everyone? I think we're just waiting for one driver, aren't we? Yeah, we're waiting for one driver.
Waiting for Bunty, yeah.
Oh, we're waiting for Bunty, yeah, because we're just waiting for an Alfa Romeo. So thanks to pretty much everyone, apart from Bunty, for going into the lobby promptly. And I think Old School won't be selecting his car, I believe, until he sets up the grid. So that's why he hasn't selected his car yet. But let us know your prediction chat, who you think's going to win the race and who you think's going to get the podium. And yeah, I'm very, very excited for this one. I would go through the permutations, but they're very long, so I'll go through them as we go through the session, the ones that are relevant, because it's a bit complicated, because it's got fastest laps permutations as well. And but anyway, at least we got those. But hurry up, because otherwise I'm literally gonna go in with like hardly any practice tonight. But anyway, oh, Bunty's in. Okay, so Old School just need to set up the grid, and then we'll be good to go.
Yeah, so I think this is going to be very interesting. I really don't know how this is going to play out, to be honest with you. Again, apologies the fact that this is taking so long. Hopefully we can get this going ASAP. But yeah, I don't know. Do you reckon there could be someone that might make their way through that field? I know Hungary isn't exactly a track for overtaking, but other than probably Rick, do you maybe see anybody else making their way up through the field at all?
I'm just trying to look at the wet races we've had on the calendar to see who would actually climb their way up. Like I said, Rex, I think, will do quite well. He had his first win in Silverstone, and he got a podium last time out as well, so expect to see him up there. Actually, no, I was looking at the wrong person. I was looking at Miami, but he's not here tonight. But I think I could see Rex doing well. I'm sure he doesn't want a DNF in like he did in Portugal, but there we go. Anyone else? RJ maybe could be a big surprise. Type obviously has got to stay where he is. I'm expecting Cam to do well tonight. He scored 6 points in the wet race around Portugal, well, changeable conditions around Portugal as well, so I expect him to climb up a few places. He did last week as well, and I said, oh, he was doing well, and I commentated Kirsty and he had a spin. So, yeah, I'm going to shut up about that. And, oh, that was quick. Thank you to Old School for getting the grid up very, very quickly. And we should be good to go for 35 laps around Hungary. So about half an hour later than intended. But anyway, we're good to go anyway.
Yeah, no, finally we're actually able to go ahead with that. It is still going to be a wet start as well, so I really don't know how this is still going to play out. Again, it's whoever's going to get our best start, I think, is going to be the one that ends up taking this win, in my opinion. Again, especially in the wet, you're not going to have any DRS or anything like that. And the only DRS zones are literally from the start-finish line and turn to and turn one. That's it. Now, other than that, you more than likely will have to sit behind whoever it is that you're chasing for the entire lap. So, I'm kind of intrigued to see how this is going to go down.
Yes, so since obviously it was a dry qualifying session, we don't have to worry about what tyres people were on. So that is good, because usually there's a rule in lobby restarts that if it's a dry qualifying and a dry start to the session, all 20 drivers, and it doesn't matter where you are, will have to start on the tyre that pretty much they were going to start in the formation lap. But since we didn't get into the formation lap, I think they would have free choice of tyre anyway, if that was the case. It was only if there was a few laps gone in the race and they decided to have a lobby restart. So they would have had free choice of tyres anyway. Fresh set of tyres as well. Is there the rule that they also have to have the same setup they set in qualifying, or can they retweak their setup a little bit? What's the rule? Because I haven't seen this happen in ages.
I would say they have to stay with the same setup.
Okay.
However, we can't exactly prove that they are going to have the same setup. So, I mean, okay. I we can only say, yeah, you can have the same setup, but we can't exactly say, oh, yeah, tell us what your setups are. So we can only just try and enforce it. There's not much we can do if people do change it. So, yeah, I don't know how this is going to play out, to be completely honest with you. But I suppose we'll see. We'll see. It doesn't look like it's actually raining as heavy as what it was previously. Well, I don't know.
It was chucking it down in the first lobby. Yeah. You guys didn't see it because I had the Hungary image screen, but I definitely saw it was chucking it down more as well. But we can't afford another restart, because otherwise we're going to be here all night. So, yeah, I think the drivers have got to deal with the inter weather while in the full wet. But to be fair, I think if I was in a driver's scenario, I think pray to the gods that this has happened rather than a full wet. So, that'll be good. And I think I did see that it's going to be it for the whole session, unless old school has changed it to custom, but I don't think that's probably happened. But like we said, no time for another lobby restart. And I was going to get the tyres up, but they're all on inters anyway. But I'll go through your running order then, for those of you that just joined us, because it's been a long while since we started qualifying, believe it or not. So Tope will be starting on pole. Then we've got Bunty in the Alpha on the front row. Then we've got Neil Shendrick in third, Brent in fourth, Marty in fifth, RJ in sixth, Luke in seventh. Then we've got Rex in eighth, YHYY in ninth, we've got Maverick in tenth. And then we've got Cam in 11th, J-Luke in 12th, McCurrick in 13th, but I expect him to be the big movers, as we said earlier. Old School 14th, Noah in 15th, Matt's in 16th, Chill 17th, Charlie 18th, and Darry in last, because he joined late in the qualifying session. Doesn't look like we have any problems, because there's hardly any complaints in the chat, so we can get going finally. But I think we could expect... Hopefully we won't expect the same thing we saw last season in real life, where we saw Valtteri Bottas went into a few cars in Turn 1 and costed a few drivers race. I think it took three or four drivers out of the race, and quite a lot of people, including Max Verstappen, got a bit of damage. And who remembers the time where Esteban Ocon, he got his first race win around this track as well. I'm trying to think if anyone could get their first win in Division 3, but we'll see as the session goes on. But I'm expecting, I think, Tope to get another dub ski tonight. I think he's been practicing a lot, and he also likes the wet conditions, and let's just hope he has a good getaway as well. But watch out for Bunty as we head towards Turn 1.
Yeah, no, without a doubt. Obviously, as I said, it's Neil Shendrick's first race in Division 3, so we could be seeing him potentially take a win for tonight as well. Marty as well, again, I know you said he's quick around one lap and not exactly the best in a race. If he does improve on that, I don't know if wet weather might even suit him more. If it does, then we could be seeing the Bulgarian potentially get himself a win tonight, or at least on the podium. I think the best place he's actually finished so far this season is in P9. So, again, I know he has qualified up a lot higher than that at other races. But I don't know. We'll see how this is going to go. Five red lights should be going out very soon, Jess. I'll let you take it away.
Thank you. So it's going to be a long hold, actually. So hopefully the lights can get on very, very soon. Come on, game. Come on. any time today. Thank you very much. The drivers are raring to go. We are raring to go. I'm sure you guys are raring to go as well. Come on. Come on, game. Oh, God. Hopefully we won't have another lobby restart. Who is it having trouble this time? Is it... Oh, Maverick is in a weird... Is it Maverick that's having issues? Because he's got a down arrow for me at the moment. I can't see anything going on here. Oh, great. Okay.
I'm being told it was Luke.
It was Luke. Okay, so 5 red lights are on. We're about to get underway here at the Hungaroring, and it lights out, and away we go. We'll see who has the best start. Our Top and Bunty actually heading towards turn one. It's actually Bunty, like we said, that didn't have a poor start, but he's getting a good run in towards turn number one on the Top. Top wasn't very comfortable on traction, but Bunty's gone wide into turn two, so that is allowing Top to take the race lead. But Luke having a great battle with Bunty heading towards this next section, which is a DRS zone in obviously the dry conditions, but in the wet is very, very tricky indeed. Who else has made up ground? Right, well, why up into 8th position? We've got Noah J, he's down one place there. He's moved up into 18th. We've got McCurry trying to make his ground as well, up into 13th position. So much chaos at the moment. Neil just dropped down a few places up to 9th position right now as well. Biggest loser, I have to say, would be Noah J, but we're seeing Rex trying to get a move before the double chicane. That's very, very brave. My sunshine up into 6th place. I said he will have a good start, and Rex is having a good start. But Bunty, well, Tobe had the best launch. Bunty had a good run into turn one, but it's just, well, he went wide into the braking zone, and that just didn't work for him, unfortunately. I think he just got a bit too greedy, unfortunately. But yellow flag, that is Noah J. I'm not really that surprised, to be honest.
Yeah, so Noah J unfortunately having that spin a little bit further up in the field. Brent and Neil Shendrick just trading places as well. Neil Shendrick didn't actually exactly have the best start either. Interestingly enough, the Ghost of Luke made up, I think it was 4 positions at the start of the race. So he ended up in 2nd and is now dropped back down into 3rd position after Buddy overtaken. And Brent going down the inside of Neil Shendrick in towards turn number 1 in the wet conditions. Is Brent going to be able to get this one done? I think he might have done. I'm going to run on board with Neil Shendrick. Yes, he certainly has. Brent getting himself up into P4. Good move for Dutchman getting himself up into there as well. And you can already see Bunty and Tope have already completely pulled away from the rest of the guys. Noah J already into the pits, I think, for a front wing change. Yep, he's getting his front wing changed and doing his first stop already. So yeah, Luke just dropping back massively from those front two. Might be under pressure from Brent very, very soon as well, as we come towards the end of the lap. A little bit further down though, Cam K up in 11th position now at least. And well, he sort of kept the same position. Old school making up a couple of moves from the beginning as well, right behind his teammate who is still fighting within this championship. And just in front of him is one of the championship protagonists, teammates of YHYY. Again, I know YHYY is, well, both of the Finns are quite fiendish in the wet, so I'm not going to expect YHYY to be a bit of a slouch in this race, and in fact might even see the Finnishman try and make a few moves in these wet conditions. To say that though, he has a little bit of an oversteer moment just before the penultimate corner. But yeah, I think we could be seeing the two Haas boys. I know that what they're capable of in the wet conditions, we might be able to see them make some moves as well. As Topia now just starting to pull away a little bit more from Bunty. Bunty starting to pull away from the rest of the grid, and Neil Shendrick starting to drop back, in fact, from Luke and Brent. So in his first race, not going too well for Neil Shendrick. Again, he's dropped down 2 positions, but I mean, there's still the opportunity of him being able to do it. We're only on lap 3 off 35, so anything can still happen within this race.
Yes, like you said, anything can happen, and it usually does. As J Luke has had a bit of a moment, and he's lost a few positions because of that as well. He's got passed by both Charlie and Maverick, and he's made a bit of contact with Mats as well. That's another ball from him, unfortunately. His season has not gone the best, and he's got no front wing as well, so he will have to go into the pits. And having no front wing in the wet around Hungary is not a perfect matchup for J Luke, so he's going to struggle a little bit. So it's going to be yellow flags at some point as well. Luke obviously gained the most positions due to his AI, but he is holding ground over trying to catch up to Bunty, but Bunty is pulling away, whereas Brent, meanwhile, you can tell Brent is faster on traction as we head towards what corner is it? I think it's turn 12 and towards turn 13 they go, and Noah J gets a 3 second time penalty. Time penalties will be common in the works. A few people will probably go wide as well. And I have to say about the intermediate compounder tyres, they can last around about 22 laps, same as the medium compounder tyres. So if it was to be like this for the whole session, well, they could pit nice and early, go on to a set of the intermediate tyres, and they can get it to the end. Well, I was able to make Inters last a long time during practice, so anyone can do it. These guys can do it in Division 3 because obviously they're better at tyre management than me as well. So no major battles right now, it's all possession at the moment. Ignore the yellow flags. The yellow flags keep appearing at the same corner, but we do have a yellow flag in set to two as Tope and Bundy just passed, but that was another weird one. Okay, that is interesting. But Brent, he's caught up a little bit more to the back of Luke.
Yeah, no, he certainly has. Luke has completely dropped off from those top two guys as well, but has managed to pull away from the rest of the grid. So yeah, Tope, Bundy, again, I think just showing the class of the field at this present moment. And Tope, I think, is looking like he's going to be extending his championship again. I know it's only lap number 4 of 35, but at this point, it's looking like Tope, I don't think, is going to be... It's a bit unstoppable at the moment in this division. Brent, like you say, all over the back of Luke. Luke, again, I know this is AI that made up those positions, but again, he's still managing to hold his own up ahead of the Dutchman down in 4th position. So Luke is doing a pretty decent job as it is, but Brent, I can see he's raring to try and get past Luke at any point right now, and you can see he's using that battery to try and get this move done on the Aston Martin. I don't think he's going to be close enough going in towards turn number 1. Is he going to get a better exit though coming out of turn number 2? He does break a little bit later than the Aston Martin, but I think he is just going to be able to hold off at the moment. So Brent is going to be able to remain in P4 and Luke going to hold off in that P3 position, and even a little bit further back as well. Rex and Neil Shendrick both, Rex is starting to close up to the back of the other Aston Martin as well. So both Aston Martins a bit under pressure, one from an AlphaTauri, one from an Alpine. And I think this is where things are going to start to get a bit more interesting now, where the tyres are starting to sort of degrade in more. I think we're going to see these intermediates, they're going to try and drag them until it becomes dry. I don't think we'll see anybody try and make a pit stop for another set of intermediate tyres because it'll just lose them too much time. So I think we will see these guys try and drag out these intermediates as long as they possibly can to avoid having to try and make another pit stop, because I think a pit loss around is about 18 odd seconds, which they're not going to be able to make up if they're all still on the same tyres. So I think we're going to see these guys try and hold out these intermediates until it becomes a bit drier.
Yeah, I have to say, I agree with that as well. And even though my stat says 23 laps, well, I've seen Inters can go 27, 28 laps. So it could last pretty much most of this race in these conditions. But as soon as it gets drier, then the tyres will wear more on the Inters. So you don't really want to be staying on the Inters for far too long. So I think if anyone who has bad time management in this division, well, let's hope they don't tonight, because otherwise we're going to see quite a few punches as Bundy's gained quite a lot of time to Tope. So I wonder if Tope is struggling to warm his tyres a little bit more, or I wonder if Bundy is pushing ever so slightly. As I'm looking at his ERS, he's doing fine on the ERS, but you can see Tope is definitely pushing with his overtake when he doesn't need to, which is very, very great to see. But don't forget, they don't have the DRS assistant needed, so it's all about the slipstream. Again, no one has made ground since lap 2, so I think it's going to come down to, like he's saying, the strategy and who could get the undercut right, who will put on the right tyres at the right times as well, and that will be the key as to who wins and who loses in this championship fight right now. As I think, pretty much everyone from P5 downwards up down to P15, now on this big train right now, and it's impossible to get the move done if you're in that train. I think it will take one person to blink and cause a stir for it to be chaos, and then some more people start to get some moves done as well. Brent, you just can't overtake at the moment. The dirty air is awful. I hope that it's fixed for the F122 game, because in real life it is shown that without the dirty air you can follow a little bit closer. And that does mean closer racing, so hopefully overtaking will improve on next year's game around the Hungary. As Brent heads towards turn number 1, can he get the overtake done on Luke? No, he does not. So Luke is staying ahead of Brent 4 now. Niels has got a penalty, though. He's been chased by Rex and Marty. I wonder if the two LPs will be working together, or will there be some sort of team orders going on here?
Nah, I'd surely, if they try and play this right, they can both work it together and get themselves past Niels as well. But Niels, I think, is now starting to close up ever so slightly to the back of Luke and Brent. I think Luke just holding up these lot a lot more than previously as well. But yeah, Luke at the moment still just remaining in that P3 position. Brent still trying to find any sort of way past that he possibly can. Unfortunately, not going to be able to get himself through at this present moment. But yeah, I mean, at the start of the race, it was to be expected. I knew it was going to be sort of the case that Hungary is not the easiest track to overtake around, so I'm not surprised that it's been a little bit dull at the start of this race. Obviously, we're only on lap number 7 now of 35. Tope still is the one that is in the lead of this race. Bunty is in second. 5 seconds is the gap behind him of Luke in third. So yeah, like I said, Tope and Bunty are just at the moment in a class of their own. Brent is really trying to find a way past Luke. If he can try and get a better exit out of this final corner, I think the Dutchman might have a good chance. And I think, he has gotten a better exit out of that final corner. Luke is using a bit more of his ERS, though. And in fact, he saved up a bit more of his ERS in comparison to the Dutchman. So Luke, I think, is still going to be able to hold on to this P3 position at the moment. Again, unless a mistake happens. Like you say, if someone blinks when they're not supposed to, I say not when they're supposed to, but at the wrong time, then it literally can cause something happening within this midfield. And you can already see the gaps are starting to separate a lot. I mean, Rex and Marty's dropped back now 1.1 seconds behind his teammate, and then you've got Y closing up to the back of Marty, and then you've got RJ, who's 1.1 seconds behind him, and then Old School closing up, and then Cam K a little bit further behind as well. So the gaps are starting to open up ever so slightly more. And I think Marty's really struggling. I wonder if the Bulgarian's actually got himself any wing damage, because he wasn't that far behind Rex before. YHYY is catching him very, very quickly.
Yeah, so I wonder so as well. Maybe he's just struggling with the tyres. He's maybe overheating as well when he doesn't need to, because the tyre pressures can be configured differently for each setup, and the drivers do have the choice in that compared to other games. On all four of your tyres, it used to be the front and the rears, like they have two sliders, but now there are four sliders. So I wonder if Marty has configured something wrong there. Maybe he's shrugging out, or you probably might be right, he probably might have damage, but we don't know. We will see as he goes into the pits. And you can see Tope and Bunty at the moment working together to make sure as Matt gets a 3 second time. But we got a safety car, someone's gone off. That is Maverick. Where did he retire then? I'm just trying to see. I'll go on. I think I'll be too late before going on board with Matt's. But that is turn number just in the middle of turn 13 in towards turn 14 there. So a bad afternoon for Maverick once again. Another DNF to add to his list. That is not good. I literally don't know what I would do if I was if these drivers, to be honest, because it's going to dry up later on. But would you take a free pit stop to go on fresh inters, or would you want track position? I wouldn't have a clue. So if these drivers have a Jeff, that would really help them right now. As Matt has got a drive through, speeding on the safety car. Tuts up, Matt. That is not what you want to do. And you can't serve a drive through until after the safety car.
Yeah, that's a bit interesting for Matt. So I'm not too sure how he's managed to go about with that one. But the guys at the front, they're not going to know what to do whatsoever. They have got that little bit of a 3 second buffer. However, if guys go on a fresh set of the intermediates, they're going to be a bit quicker than what they are at the moment on these current set of intermediate tyres. However, like you say, track position at the moment is key. Do I see anybody else coming in other than maybe a couple of the back markers? I don't think anyone's coming in. I think they're all going to be staying out, and I think they're all going to try and drag these tyres that little bit further. Tope is staying out. Bunty is staying out. Luke is staying out. Brent is coming in, interestingly enough. Neil Shendrick, I think, went off ever so slightly, but is staying out as well. Rex, Marty, YHYY, RJ, Old School. Cam K's in, so Cam's coming in as well as FRL Charlie. All of those guys making their way into the pits. I think Darry's that's the one call for them, especially Brent. Yeah, and Darry's in as well. So I think Brent, he's made the wrong call, in my opinion. You can't really overtake around here, and he's proved that with how difficult it has been to overtake Luke. He's basically just lost himself P4. just from making that early, or making that pit stop, I think Brent has lost himself P4 in this, and at the moment he's now just going to be battling just for a scrape of a point.
Exactly. I'm a bit worried for Brent as well, because if there's a track like, let's say, Austria, Belgium, where it's so easy to overtake, Bahrain, I think you could argue you can overtake. Let's look at some tracks on the calendar where you can actually overtake quite nicely. I think Imola, questionable. Portugal, you could overtake. So could Austria. So can Silverstone. Jeddah, you could do overtakes as well. But here, definitely not in these wet conditions. So it's Monaco without the barriers for a reason, because you can barely overtake. So yeah, I'm a bit worried. If it was tracks where you can overtake, yeah, that's probably the right decision. But yeah, I have to say, wrong call for these guys. Unless people at the front struggle with tyre temps and worry about punches, or maybe they think the rain's going to come pretty much, go a bit later on in the session. They're going to be on fresher tyres compared to the ones that stayed out. They're not going to be worried about the puncher. If it stays like this for the rest of the session, their tyres could get to the end, whereas everyone else will need to make another pit stop. So for these guys, they hope the rain's going to come as soon as... Well, the rain's going to leave pretty much towards the end of the race. With the likes of Taupe all the way down to P11, they're going to hope the rain goes away ASAP, really, because otherwise they will be dropping way down right now, unless they can pull a decent gap and work together to try and keep the ones on the fresher tyres behind right now. And Charlie's already a lap down, I believe. So, unfortunately, on this game, unlapped cars can't unlap themselves, which I will need to double check if they got that feature for the next game, but I don't think so. But that is annoying for Charlie. I think his days are numbered, unfortunately. But he's still going. Fair play to him. It shows that if you pretty much persevere, you'll get through this. And Charlie may think there may be a lot of retirements in this race, so he can still salvage some points. Top 12, don't forget, score points in other ways. So Charlie could still get it miraculously, but he needs a miracle.
I think it's actually the game. I don't think Charlie is a lap down. I'm not too sure what is happening, but I think this could be the cause of those constant yellow flags that you might be seeing. Charlie isn't actually a lap down. He's been keeping up with the rest of the guys. He, in fact, pit with Kamke and Brent. So I don't know what's been going on, but I think it's slightly glitched for Charlie anyway. But he is definitely in P14. He's not down in 19th in last or anything like that. Yeah, I think I really don't know how the rest of this is going to play out, to be honest with you. Tobe and Bunny again have been the absolute class of the field so far. Luke, he's done well to hold off Brent and started to get away from his reserve teammate of Neil Shendrick as well. And Neil was under a lot of pressure from Rex before that as well. We have, of course, got to wait for Tim Mats to make his way up towards the safety car. So we're going to have another lap under the safety car, and all of this really is going to be helping out the guys that haven't made their pit stop as of yet. I know you said the intermediates could possibly go maybe 22 to 29 laps. I think if it does manage to stay as the wet tires the entire way, these guys on the intermediates, they don't necessarily have to stop. They could try and take these all the way to the end. It happened last week in China in Division 1. I think we could be seeing maybe a similar scenario if it does not dry up in tonight in Division 3. Tobe and Bunty might try and go to the end of the race. Again, if it doesn't dry up, it is due to dry up, but if it doesn't dry up, then we might be seeing these guys try and drag these intermediates all the way to the end of the race. Again, I know they're going to try and drag it until it does get dry and then maybe go for a dry tire, but if they can manage their tire wear as much as they can, we might be seeing them trying to drag these tyres not only to the dry, but even to the end of the race.
That is a good point, actually. I completely forgot, because if you're on the intermediate tyre and it stays like this for the whole race, you don't have to pit onto a set of the dries. You could pretty much go and last the whole distance there as well. Realistically, the tyres won't be able to make it, but if you do a bit of tyre saving, and you can, then it shouldn't be a problem. It is starting to get a bit, clearer at the moment. The sun is starting to peak up just a little bit in the clouds. So, this could get interesting at the moment. As we said, the rain is meant to get lighter in towards the final few slots on the weather system, and then it's going to get overcast, and then it's going to get clear again. So safety car is in this lap, and Taupe is going to be the de facto safety car, and he is going to pretty much control the pace, and he's going a little bit faster than intended, but as long as he goes on the safety car restart line, he can choose when he wants to go. He can't speed up and then slow down again, because that's illegal, unfortunately. But if you just keep a certain pace, and as soon as he accelerates, that's when other people can go, as he's going right now, actually. And that's caught Bunty off guard a little bit, but he can't overtake yet until the start-finish straight. So we're going green then here at the Hungara Ring, and there's yellow flags everywhere at the moment, which is not ideal, which means people can't overtake yet. As Rex tries to go down the right-hand side into turn number one, can he keep it steady in the wet conditions? He's going to try at least. He's up to P4 already. We've got Old School that got past his teammate of RJ up into eight. Then we got Chill, who's got past Cam Noah. Jay's got past Darien. RJ once again fighting off Old School. This is a big rivalry that's happening at the moment between these two. But I'm betting they're working together. Are you seeing yellow flags everywhere on your screen?
Yeah, Brent's just got on a 5-second penalty for ignoring them. I would have thought Rex would be in a second as well. I think that's why RJ's got on back past Old School.
God.
I think this lobby is completely glitched.
It is. Because we've seen the yellow flags around this part of the track here every lap. And I think Charlie's been having internet issues, because everyone else... For everyone else, he says he's a lap down. For him, he said he's P14. I think he's still P14. Let me have a look. Yeah, he is still P14. He's ghost on my screen as well. So, yeah. So, please, let's hope this is not like this for the rest of the race. Because, we can't have another lobby restart, because us two have got races to go to. So if this carries on, we don't know what we're going to do in this situation. But it's still Taupe that leads, Bunty second, Luke third, Rex in fourth. Did Rex get away with overtaking Niels there? I think he did. Or was he ahead of him anyway before the restart?
No, he actually got ahead of him literally after the restart, when the whole constant yellow flags were there. So... I don't know. I really don't know, to be completely honest with you, how he's gotten away with it. Yeah, I really don't know how he's managed to sort of come away with getting up ahead of Neil, but I mean, he's done it anyway. Everyone's sort of still just sort of filtering through Old School, holding up Rick as best as he possibly can for that P9 spot. But again, I don't think he's going to be able to overtake him without getting a penalty.
Yeah. I think that's what he's trying to do. Come on, gang, get rid of the yellow flag. I think it's Charlie. So, Charlie, if you're in the lobby, I think you're the one causing these issues. You probably have to retire and leave the session. As Noah J has also got a 5-second penalty for doing that. I think it's either Charlie or Luke. I don't think it's Luke, because Luke's having no problems at all. He's not desync on my screen. So, yeah, Charlie, unfortunately, will need to leave, I think. It might be... I might be wrong, but... Apparently he's decent for quite a few people, including J-Luke, so... if Charlie leaves, hopefully the problems will be sorted. Because he always seems to be yellow flags when he goes past, I think, a few laps ago, so... Still yellow flags again, oh, for goodness sake. Game!
Well, I think we might see it here. Rick going to try and go for this move on Old School in towards turn number one. He's very close to the back of the McLaren. He's going for that move down the inside. This is a battle of the ages. If you was a bit of an OG, you'd be knowing that this battle would be very, very spicy. Rick versus Old School. Old School's going to try and hold it down the inside of the Finn. Rick going to give him that room. Old School's also going to give him that room. Both still will banging side to side of each other. 9th and 10th for this battle. Rick going to try and hold it down the inside in through turn number 3. Still both side by side, and I think Rick is going to be able to just get that one down. He does, and in fact, Old School pushing Brent off track as well. I don't think he realised Brent was trying to go for that move there as well, and where Mark just moved straight back onto the racing line, Brent was there on the right-hand side. So, yeah, I finally we're back under green flag racing. I don't know how. I don't know if it was that Charlie has left or what, but we're, yeah, back under green flags now,
Charlie
which
has
is good
left.
To see.
Charlie has left.
Right. Gotcha.
Was Charlie. It was Charlie.
Yeah. Yeah, that's very, very strange, but yeah. Thank God for that.
Well, do drivers get warned about internet problems? I think they do, don't they? So I'm sure the steward will pick up on it. But let's go for your order then. Now the yellow flag bit is out the way. No yellow flags are set to two either, thank goodness. So Tope is leading by 2 seconds over Bunty. So he's been helped a lot during this yellow flag debacle. Luke in third, Rex in fourth. Who's the closer to making a move? I don't think anyone is close to making a move. I think Darry, who started last, don't forget, is doing that. Is Charlie's AI is trying to get past Noah J for P13. Can't quite do it at this moment in time. We've got Brent in the pit after him getting spun, and he's got a 5-second penalty to serve as well. Has I think Matt to serve this drive through? Let me have a look. Yes, he has served this drive through. It's all good. Yeah. So he served it after the safety car. Brent comes out onto a fresh set of mediums again. Has nailed it out of the race. Oh, that is... Oh, that's a nasty crash. Another safety car. Oh, this race is going to go on forever. But I would stay out. It's proven that if you've pitted, it's hard to overtake. No one has been able to overtake the ones who stayed out. I would stay out. I know it's going to get better. It is lightening up. It is less rain than it was at the start, but I would stay out at this stage because you're going to lose so much more time. But unfortunate for Niels on debut to a tyre like that. So easy doing the work. What a shame. But there's still hope for next week.
Yeah, no, that Niels very unfortunate for that one. But yeah, managing to... very unfortunate for just crashing out, but... A good solid performance for those first 15 laps from him. But yeah, I'll be surprised if anyone comes into the pits. As I say, that Noah J into the pits to get a new set of intermediate tyres. He was one of the ones that actually pit as well under that previous safety car. Charlie's AI is also coming in. Noah J serving that 5-second penalty that he got for an illegal overtake. So that's that done for him. Matt still has, of course, that 3-second time penalty that he got earlier on. Brent has served his 5 seconds. I think Brent really has been saved by that safety car, because now he can just sort of come close back up to the back of everybody, and basically a little bit of a restart from him there. So we'll see how that does fare on. Tope and Bunty, though, again, still just outclassing the entire field at the moment, and there's not much really to say, because again, it's only been about another 3 laps of racing since that safety car came in. So yeah, Tope just still holding off against Bunty. He had a very good restart previously. We'll see how he does again on that second safety car restart.
Yes, I think Tope's going to be leading once again. Pretty much the order has not changed since the first one, so, but this time hopefully we can actually go green flag racing as soon as the safety car leaves, well, goes into the pit lane. So as with Niels out the race then, that means we've got 16 drivers left as Brent. Wait a minute. 5-second penalty for ignoring yellow. Are they still under Delta? I don't know.
That was Charlie's AI, I think.
Oh, it must have been Charlie's AI. Yeah, it was. I think, to be honest, that will probably get removed. I won't be surprised if that's removed, to be honest, because he would have got held up otherwise as well. So yeah, I think I'm almost certain Brent's going to get that 5-second removed unless he goes into the pits. If he goes into the pits, I think that won't be a... I think he would have to. He would have to serve it. But if he doesn't have to go in, then it will get removed. So yeah, a bit unfortunate again. Hopefully he won't get the same more as well. Is anyone around? I think Charlie's rejoined, I think. And he's in the pits. According to my end, that is a weird game. Brent is in, so I thought he could get that removed personally, but obviously not. He's going in to serve it. I wouldn't have done that, I would, because I thought I would get it removed, but better to be safe than sorry. He was near the back anyway, so he's got nothing to lose.
Yeah, so he's serving that 5-second penalty, as you can see. Brent is obviously going to have to try and close back up. Obviously, if he does, then the safety car will be in at this lap. If not, then it will obviously be staying out for yet another lap. Charlie has now left the session once again. So, yeah, I think that's basically going to be him out of this race as well, unfortunately, for him. I can't believe that this whole thing is going on still. So, yeah, that's a fun one.
Well, I think the game has picked an interesting week for the glitches to happen when Aiden's not here. So, yeah. To be honest, I think Aiden's probably glad he's missing this race with all that glitches, because you know what he would have been like. He would have been screaming at his TV. So, because he would have been annoyed, I think, just like he was annoyed in Monaco. But hey-ho, is safety car going to be coming in this lap? Nope, it's
not. No, it'll be next lap.
It will be next lap. Oh, yeah, because Brent still needs to catch up. Fair enough. So, Brent has another chance to get back in this as well. Noah is now out the race. He's binned it. Where has he binned it? Oh, okay. He's gone wide there. I wonder if he's given up in frustration. It sounded like it, but... And he said hopefully nobody saw that. Yeah, I think he retired on purpose there. I think it was a rage quit.
It might have been. I'm not too sure, to be honest with yourself. But, yeah, so Noah J out now. That's the fourth person that's technically out of this race, obviously Charlie, with Neil Shendrick and Alt Maverick as the first DNF as well. Brent, again, not exactly had a good race. Bunty spun!
No!
Bunty spun under the safety car!
Oh, he's done a George Russell! He's done a George Russell from Imola 2 years ago. And Bunty, the man who was going to challenge Tobe for the win, has spun. His tyres are absolutely cut. And guess who he's got in front of him? He's got his teammate Chill. So I wonder if Bunty's having trouble with his tyres, what's it going to be like for everyone else who's on worn tyres? I think they may struggle as well. Or maybe Bunty was just pushing a little bit too much during the race and maybe everyone else is managing their tyres. So that means Luke is up to second, Rex up to third, Marty is up to fourth. Oh my goodness, Marty. Let me see where he is in the championship. P18, he scored no points in the last two rounds. The highest he ever finished was 10th in France. And Danvoort. He could get P4. He could get a podium here as well. I'm not going to jinx it, touch word. I'm not going to jinx it, but stop the count right now. Marty's in a good position at the moment. Safety car's in this lap. Hopefully no yellow flag debacle, please.
Yeah, hopefully not, but so yeah, we'll see how Tope's going to end up leading this restart. I think he's if he's going to do what he did last time, he might end up going maybe even a little bit earlier than before. Looking at it, Rex obviously trying to sort of eye up Luke to try and go for something possibly as an early safety car restart. But let's have a look, Tope. In fact, he's already gone, I believe. So yeah, Tope has gone at the penultimate corner, and again, that's kept Luke, Rex, and Marty has been left for dust from his teammate. Watch out, Wyatt might even try and pressure him coming up in towards the fight, in towards turn number one. But let's have a look. I'm going to run on board of Rex because look how close he is to the back of Luke. Luke might be under pressure from the Alpine coming up in towards turn one. The American's not going to be able to go for any sort of move on the Aston Martin. I don't think there's any moves that are going on in towards turn one. But Rex got a better exit than Luke coming out of turn number one. He's going to try and go around the outside of him in towards turn number two. Luke's going to be able to hold this one down on the inside. But Rex going to try and go for a bit of a better exit, a little bit of contact between the pair of them. That's going to lose some time from Tope. Tope already now 1.5 seconds up ahead of the Aston Martin. Luke does hold on to that P2 position, a little bit shoved out from Rex, but at the same time he has managed to hold that position in the end. Watch my white going very wide out of turn number four. RJ now being pressured. It's again this championship battle, Rick versus RJ for P6. RJ is still holding that sixth position at the moment. Rick down in seventh, and I think we're going to again now we're going to just start seeing a lot more gaps pull away, especially at the front. Luke already 1.5 seconds behind Tope. Rex obviously playing that factor into that, trying to go for that move relatively early to try and follow with Tope, but unfortunately just didn't get that move done. And now, as I said, two of the championship protagonists going at it for that P6 position.
Luke and Rex up 5 places, Vukurik and Old School up 6 places. Biggest gainer, Chill, up 8. Biggest losers, Bunty down 8, and Brent down 11 due to him pitting at the moment. Also, we've got Charlie, who is now towards the back of the field, I believe. Yes, he is now towards the back of the field. So it is an issue with his game, unfortunately. But we could see, I think, a change for, I would say, P7. Vukurik's trying to maybe send up the inside on RJ to turn one. Can he do it once again? No, he does not. As there are going to be potentially issues with ERS towards the end of this race, and I think, if my eyes are deceiving me, I believe it stopped raining. I might be wrong. There's no rain on the track at the moment. It's just only a damn track right now. So the question is, when is the track going to be enough for slick tyres, if any? So, yeah, that means the ones we pitted for Inters earlier, they are absolutely gutted because they will have to pit again for slicks, most likely, unless it stays like this.
Yeah, no, the guys that did actually pit twice, the guys that did actually pit before, I say they have messed this up completely. Brent could skip past J. Luke as well at the exit of, I believe, at the chicane through turn number 6 and turn number 7. So Brent now making his way up into P13. One more position and he's back into the set of the points. But yeah, again, there's been so much that's been going on this race. Old School now 1 second behind Rick. So he's starting to drop back. Chill 1 second behind Old School. And Bunty trying to pressure his teammate to get in a move done. Chill does go by it at the penultimate corner. And Bunty has sort of just followed him through that. So yeah, the two Alfa Romeos, I think, are going to be going at it. Taupe now starting to get that little bit quicker. And Luke, 2.3 seconds behind Taupe now. And again, Rex has now started to drop back from Luke, so we're starting to see a big set of gaps making their way within this field. Rex is having a little bit of an oversteer moment coming out of turn number 1 as well. So yeah, I think it's all gonna be chopping and changing at the moment. Bunty and Chill both going side by side, and in fact Chill, I think, is gonna be able to hold off from his teammate Bunty though. So he's gonna try and go back around the outside on his teammate. They're both still side by side through it, but Chill, I think, is just gonna be able to hold off that position from the CPI driver in the end. So both of the Alfa Romeos going at it, and now again that's more time being lost to the guys up in front. Now 1.3 seconds behind Old School, and even then Old School's not even making any inroads on those guys up in front. Rick still trying to put that pressure on RJ to get that move done for P6 and get even more points on him in this championship. Again though, Taupe, if it does end up finishing like this, Taupe will end up going into the lead of this championship by, if my maths does not mistake me, if Luke finishes in second, he gets on 157 points. Taupe goes up to 185. Rick will actually go up to 165 points. So it will be a 20 point gap between Taupe and Rick for this championship if it does finish the way that it does at the moment. So I think Taupe might look like he will be running away with this championship. Even come the next round, he could potentially take could almost basically touch in one hand on that trophy for the championship.
Kerrick almost had a slide there going towards the start finish straight there. That was very, very close into an instant. Luckily, he saved the car just in time there, which meant he lost time to RJ, which is a bit unfortunate, but that's given RJ a bit of breathing space to chase down YHYY. Bunty once again went side by side with Chill into the first corner once more, and he's up into P9, surely where he doesn't want to be right now, but at least he's having a good fight. Nonetheless, we've got Brent trying to fight Cam once again. We've got a big train from P9 up to P12. And look at that exit that Cam's trying to get. But Brent has even more better traction heading towards Sector 2 now. And I have to say, this could be very intriguing to see who's got the final point, because Dari's in that train, so is J-League as well. It will become a DRS train when it is enough for the six tyres. And I think I'm expecting pretty much one of these guys who is in this train to make the first move and when to pit. It's too early now, I would say, but I've seen it when people pit when the track's like this and then it's completely dry lap later, but you never know. It's taking a long time though for the... There is some dry patches though, I think, on the right hand side of Sector 3, and it's just like Imola last week in real life. They're just trying to find the wet line. They can't afford to go on the dry line because they're going to burn their tyres. Is anyone going to be brave and bold to come in? No, no one's going to be brave and bold. Boo, you're boring, guys. You're boring. But anyway, everyone's staying out. But I think it's too early anyway, so they'll be crawling otherwise. Look at how turn one is. It's still quite damp.
Yeah, I think you're right. I think we are going to start to see some slick tyres come on very, very soon. Probably within the next... I would say within the next 3 laps, we'll start to see a possible transition from dries to slicks. Rex, I think, has made a bit of a massive mistake because he's dropped back now 2 seconds from Luke, and his teammate is still holding off within about 6 tenths of a second behind Rex. So I think, yeah, Rex making a bit of a mistake. However, still driving in that P3 position at this present moment. YHYY moving his way up into fifth position. And again, still is on for a podium. He needs to get past both of these Alpines. If he can do that, then yeah, the Finn will be on for, I believe, will actually be his first podium of the season. Currently sitting in P11 at the moment. Yeah, it'll be his first podium in the season. So, I think, still got a bit of an outside chance of him getting himself on his podium. Same with Marty. Of course, the person he has to pass, though, is his teammate, which is going to be a bit of a difficult one for him. But yeah, I think we could be seeing something go down very, very soon. We've still obviously got this battle, the train going on from third all the way down into seventh. Oldschool sort of leading his own train. As J-Luke and Darry trading positions at turn number 12. As Darry now also, looking under threat from Timmats right behind him. However, Timmats, of course, has got that penalty, so I don't know if he's going to try and fight that one too hard. But yeah, again, there's that battle going down from Old School down to Bunty, and then we've got Chill all the way down to P15. And in fact, I think Cam might even be looking to go for a move on Chill in towards turn number one. He does send it down the inside, and Cam, that's a bit too much, as Brent has now also picked himself up wing damage from that happening as well. And in fact, there's people that have gone very wide. Darry's gone very wide. Cam, as I said, had that spin trying to send that down on the inside of Chill. I think that was a bit of an audacious move from the American. I could see it was going to happen, but a bit too audacious, as Darry going a bit wide out of turn number three. Camcast to try and cut across that. Timmats is now up into P11. J-Luke and Timmats, I think, must have had a bit of a collision, because J-Luke's now dropping down into P14. And yeah, J-Luke has got wing damage. He is going fast through any of these corners. Timmats is now up into 11th position. Darry into 12th. Cam K now down into 13th position and out of the points for the other American.
What a shame at the moment. I think I have to agree, Cam was a bit ambitious there as well. He's, it's up to the stewards to decide. It's not our decision, so I'm going to pass my judgment on that one as well, because it looked, to be honest, there wasn't much space at the moment, as well as Brent is crawling through the middle sector, the start of the middle sector anyway. Luckily, there was no safety car, because that would have changed this race quite considerably at the moment. Sun's still peeking down, but again, still not enough for the dry tyres. But I'm just seeing if anyone at the bottom half is going to think about pitting while J-Luke has to. I don't know, what would you go on? You would have to go on slicks, but you will lose even more time. But you'll lose more time for coming into the pits. I don't have a clue. So will J-Luke be bold? Yes, he's going bold, because he has to change his front wing anyway. But he's going on the softs. Well, I think everyone's jets are going to watch J-Luke's times to see if it's enough for the dry conditions. But to be honest, J-Luke has nothing to lose. So if he does realise he's on the wrong tyre, well, he's 14th anyway, and Brent's probably going to have to pit as well and do exactly the same thing. So the only person he's going to lose out to really is Brent. So yeah, these two have nothing to lose at this point by pitting. But I think the ones near the front, if they make the wrong decision, that's their race done, to be honest. We'll see what Tope can do. Emma Currit's got a 3-second time penalty. That can change things slightly. Brent's on the softs, actually. Is Tope coming in? Tope stays out. And I thought Luke was going to be bold then, but he just not. I'll go on board with Brent, actually, as we head towards turn number one and see. Nah, it's nowhere near dry. He's sliding all over the place. So, yeah, it's too early. But everyone's coming in. Well, not everybody, but yeah. Rex, McCurry, Old School, Chill. It's too early for the softs. Could Bunty go back into this race just by being on the right tyre? I know there's some dry patches, but it's not completely dry. I don't know. Brent's struggling. I wonder if people saw Brent and J-Luke pit and think that would be right, because the last person on those inters is Cam. And J-Luke is already losing so much time to everybody else. I'm a bit baffled right now why they've gone on the softs, but I'm not the strategist.
We'll have to see. Rex is going to be the one that we're going to have to look at him with the time in comparison to Cam K. In that first sector alone, though, he's lost about 3 tenths to the Americans. So, yeah, I think it might have been a lap too early at least. Chill picking up a 3-second time penalty. Rick as well, making that early call. I know he is one that likes to go big and bold with it and hope it works. Unfortunately, though, I don't think it has worked. And DRS has actually been enabled. So They might have actually called it right then.
That is too early. Rex is not doing too bad. He is gaining time on cam. He is gaining time on cam now. So he's probably hit the crossover point, but he's got to be careful. I still think it's too early, to be fair, but we've seen that in Imola 2021, where they called it too early, and we know what happened there. Luckily, it didn't happen this year with the same people. Not going to say who. So Luke is in. Bunty is in. They all got to go on soft tyres, obviously. Matt and Cam come in. Rex obviously stayed out with Luke. It doesn't look like it's dry enough for slicks, but Luke is sort of gaining, but sort of not. He is gaining. So, could Luke win this race? I don't know.
Well,
How many times do you lose? 21 seconds-ish. 90 to 21 seconds. Gap to leader. 22. He's got to find a second, and then he will be at the cutover for him to win. We got a yellow flag. That is... that's a Mercedes.
That's J-Luke.
So I think it's the only... I think Bren and J-Luke are the only ones to struggle on those soft tyres. Everybody else seems to be coping okay. Oh, careful! There is a move in this double chicane there between Rekurik and Chill, I believe, or Bunty. No, it is Chill at the back there as well, but they seem to be doing all right. Marty stays out, so Toad comes in. To be honest, if Toad didn't come in, he would lose so much time to Luke. So, what's happened there?
I think I've just seen something a bit interesting. I think RJ's just hit the back of Rick YTYY going into the pit, so I could be wrong, though. No, in fact, he didn't get a wing change, so I don't think he did, and neither did YTYY, so I don't know what had happened with that. I thought I saw something go flying off. But where is Luke? Luke has actually come out in front of Taupe, so Luke has gotten the undercut done, and Luke is now in the net race lead. Marty, 12 seconds now in front of the rest of the soft runners.
What have you done, Marty?
He could be, this could be a very bold strategy. He might be trying to stay out on these intermediate tyres to the end and try and just salvage as many points as he can, as RJ's actually been spun around by Bunty. RJ has been spun around by Bunty out of turn number one. Out of turn two. Brent picked himself up a 3 second time penalty, but yeah, RJ now down into 12th position. He was side by side with the Alfa Romeo, but Bunty, I don't think, left him enough space, or RJ understeered into him. I didn't properly catch it, but yeah, RJ now down into 12th position, and that is pretty much him now out of this championship fight. In fact, Bunty going down the inside of Old School at the exit of the chicane as well. A little bit of pushing going on with Old School and Bunty, but Bunty gets the move done. Taupe still not able to make any inroads on Luke, and Luke, in fact, now on for setting the fastest lap of the race so far. So Luke made the perfect time to come into the pits. Taupe has been left for it. However, I think he should pick up DRS from the stricken of J-Luke. In fact, no, he doesn't pick up any DRS. J-Luke does pick up DRS off of Luke, but Taupe doesn't pick any up off of J-Luke. So Taupe will stay down in third position at the moment. Marty, I think I'm right. I think he is trying to stay out on these intermediate tyres just to try and gain the best position he possibly can. However, he lost about 5 seconds in that lap alone to Luke. So I think Marty is going to be coming massively under pressure at the end of this race. And I think, I mean, if he would have just pit with his teammate, or at least the lap after his teammate, he still had the opportunity of at least finishing fourth. Now, I think he's at risk of just finishing just in the points. However, Rick and Chill and Matt's all with penalties to their name. He could still at least get the jump on them, as RJ and Darry both side by side now come through turn three and turn four. Darry does force out RJ, but RJ is still there on that inside. Coming up towards turn number four, RJ does back out of that one, and RJ has just spun around at turn number four. So, as I said, the championship protagonist just getting very, just driving a little bit too hot-headed now. And unfortunately for him, he's now out of the points to be able to get this done as well. So Luke trying to go for this move on Marty now for the race lead. Marty, unfortunately, isn't going to be able to have an answer for that. And that is now Luke up into the lead of the race. Marty should pick up DRS, though, from the Aston Martin. And Luke has set the fastest lap of the race. I think this is actually really helping out Taupe, because Taupe can now jump and get DRS off of Marty. And Taupe now trying to eye up that second position. However, he needs to get past Marty ASAP, as he think he does now going through turn number two. Yeah, Taupe now into second, Marty down into third position.
That is a shame for Marty. He's going to be in danger dropping down outside of the points, actually. I think if he pits now, he'll be just ahead of Cam. But if he doesn't pit now, then he's in a lot of trouble of just missing. I think he'll get in the points. He'll get in the points, fair enough. But I think, like I said earlier, J. Cole, the strategy, I think, is going to decide the race win today. That's helping Luke. That's not helping Marty right now. But to be honest, that is the sort of strategy I would do, to be fair, because usually I'm a person that likes to take the risk. And 9 times out of 10, it works wonders. But there's a few times, including this one, where it doesn't. So Marty has got to think about pitting now. He's got, because otherwise he's going to be dropping way down the field. But as Rex just got past him as well, under braking. I think YHYY is going to do the same. And I think Marty's putting his money where his mouth is and just sticking to the strategy. Fair enough. If he can hold up these look, he's going so slow at the start finish straight. The guys that are on fresh shots, they're just going to breeze past them at the moment. I don't know what I would do, but Marty, he's going to be out of the points if he carries on like this.
Yeah, no, I think Marty is actually going to be losing out for this one out of the points as well. So, YHYY, I think, is going to get this move done on Marty. In fact, going around the outside of turn number two, gets that move done now up into turn three. So, YHYY now up into fourth position, 4 seconds off of a potential podium. However, I think it was too little too late. And, yeah, those top three are completely gone. Bunty, by the way, what a recovery drive he's had, considering he had that spin under the safety car. As Marty's had that spin as well, into the wall he goes, and I think that's his front wing completely gone. So Marty tried a bold strategy, and unfortunately for the Bulgarian, it's not worked out for him. Comes back on track almost. I thought it was going to end up taking out Max with him. But yeah, Marty now completely out of this one, and I think Marty, unfortunately, not going to get himself any points for tonight. He's dropped down to 11th position already, and still will need to make that pit stop anyway. So he tried something bold. Unfortunately for him, it didn't work. And I think we're now just going to start seeing each driver just putting in their fastest laps now. Bunty still has the opportunity of finishing in fourth up ahead of YHYY. He is within that DRS as well as Old School and Chill. Rick, in fact, I didn't even realize, gotten past Old School as Chill now trying to eye up Old School as well. Old School, though, 0% ERS to his name. So he's going to be under threat for sure coming under threat from Chill very, very soon. But Rick, now up into sixth position. He has got that penalty to his name, though, so he is at threat of losing out that position to Old School. If he does, that's even more points for Tope and Luke to gain in that championship, as there's been another spinner. Once again, that is J. Luke at turn number four. So down in 15th position he is. And
he's now
been lapped. Yeah, so now been lapped. Unfortunately for him, I think he's not going to be finishing in the points tonight either. RJ, from having that spin with Bunty, he's managed to somehow scrape himself back into the points. 1 point, albeit, but at the same time, that's still at least a point that can go towards that championship. Still technically within the running, but it's I think he needs a miracle to happen if he wants to have at least a chance of being in at least a chance of being in that with the title fight. But yeah, at the moment, Luke Tope doing an exceptional job, and they're just constantly putting in fastest laps as we're now on the penultimate lap of the race. YHYY under threat now for this P4 position, and Bunty, I think we might even try to see him do something in towards turn number two at the very least. Keeping on board of him as well, and in fact, he sets the fastest lap of the race. No ERS to Bunty's name, however, but YHYY, he's got plenty in the tank for him to defend ahead of the Alfa Romeo. It's just whoever gets that better exit. It looks like YHYY is the one with the better exit, again, with more ERS to play with as well. I don't think we're going to see Bunty get past YHYY at that final lap, so I don't know. We'll wait and see, though. It's looking like it's going to be very close. The same with Chill and Old School.
Yes, indeed. Make sure you watch the penultimate few laps of this Hungarian Grand Prix. It took a while for us to get going, but we've got going in the end, and we've seen some crazy things happen. Not many overtakes, but still the overtake we saw was quite incredible, to be fair, as well. And it's Luke that still leads 1.7 seconds over Tope, but they're pulling away from the likes of Rex, who I have to say, brilliant race from him as well. And Rex and YHYY will be on for a really good result. YHYY will be on for his best result of the season. Like we said, Bungie doing well. He can actually get past YHYY very, very soon as we're about to start the final lap of this race. Bungie! Oh. Bundy's got a time penalty. That's his first. So, I think that'll allow old school to jump, at least recur it, but could he jump Bunty? I don't know. He's got to gain a lot to do so. I think he could jump both of them because of it, but still recur it. Can score some decent points, but final lap we go. Bunty's got to go for a last minute lunge in order to salvage something from this race and forget about the penalty. Dowie set the fastest lap out of this race, currently in 10th. So to be fair, from last to 10th, not too shabby, but I'm sure he wanted something too much higher. But if it was a track where you could overtake, you would have expected him to be higher. But since he started last, well, it's not a bad job. He's done an album pretty much, apart from obviously yet to pit quite late, obviously, to go onto the soft compound and tyres then. But Luke has driven a phenomenal job today. To be fair, we thought he was going to be nowhere, but this bold strategy call he made to go onto a slicks a lap before that we thought he was going to be has paid off, and he got the move done on tow very, very nicely. He took the lead after the dry stint, and he stays there. So Luke exits the final corner of turn number 15. He comes across the line in that Aston Martin and wins in Hungary. Wait, what?
Huh? That's not right.
Well, he did join during the formation lap. So Luke's gonna. So ignore Luke going down. So I believe so. Luke will win. Then it'll be Tope. Then it'll be Rex. Then it'll be YHYY. Then Bunty. Then Old School. Then Lukurik. And then it's hard to keep track of. Yeah, I've had that glitch before, where if you join after pretty much the race has started, you get that glitch. So. A shame, but yeah, I'm almost certain that Luke will get that P1 reinstated, I believe.
Yeah, no, without a doubt, Luke is the one that has taken that win tonight. The game, for some reason, has just decided to do that. But anyway, yeah, Luke takes that win. His second win of the season now as well. Tope does end up finishing in second place. So that's more of a gap that Tope has gotten. But Luke is now the one, I believe, that is... he's not even in second position in the championship. He's still third by 1 point from Rick. Rick is still second in the championship. But Tope didn't get as many points as what I thought he would get tonight. So he is still... at least 13 points, if my maths does not fail me, he's 13 points in the lead of this championship. Again, he's still technically got the one hand on that trophy. However, it just takes one mistake. And we've seen that tonight from Rick. We've seen that tonight from RJ. Luke, though, does take the win. Tope does finish in second. And Rex does finish in third on the podium. YHYY does take fourth position. Bunty in fifth as well after picking up that late time penalty. Old School does finish in sixth. Unfortunately, not able to jump Bunty, but again, does manage to finish in sixth position, so it's a good job from him. And finally moves up ahead of me in the standing, so it took him long enough. Rick does finish in seventh. Chill is in eighth. Dari in ninth. Tim Matz in tenth after a very bad start from Matz. With those safety cars, I think, just helped him out massively, and obviously everybody else having a... get a little bit too impatient. He does end up finishing in 10th in the end, so at least still a decent points position for him. Cam K in 11th, and RJ does take the final points position for tonight. Marty, unfortunately, he tried the bold strategy, just did not work out for him, and ends up finishing in 13th. Brent in 14th again after I don't know what had happened with him and everything that had just gone on with him as well. J-Luke does end up finishing 15th with the fastest lap of the race, and then our DNFers are being Charlie, Noah J, Neil Shendrick and Alt Maverick as well. Unfortunately, I don't think we've really got time to say anything else, to be honest with you, Jess, because we're actually supposed to go racing right about now. However, with all the bugs and glitches that's happened, we're still here at the moment.
Yeah, and usually we do practice before we go into our races, but we can't really do that, to be honest. So we're going to go into this race cold, but yeah, best of luck for your race, which is going to be starting in just under... it was meant to start now, but we have to join the lobby, so we will wrap this up very quickly. Thanks to all the drivers for taking part tonight. There'll be no interviews for the reason, since we started a bit late. Thank you to you lot for watching. We are next week... I don't even know where we are next week. I need to be quick because I'm meant to be in the lobby. We are in Canada. There we go. Canada next week for the Canadian Grand Prix. I absolutely love this track, so it should be a fun race. Hopefully Aiden Card will be back next week. Division 2 and Division 5 will be starting imminently once me and J. Cole get into our respective lobbies. So thank you for watching. I've been Jess, and thank you, J. Cole, for joining me tonight in the place of Aiden. We will see you next week for the Canadian Grand Prix. Goodbye.